Hello everyone, in this video I'm going to talk about the synthesis of Avatrombopag, a medication approved by the United States Food and Drug Administration and the European Medicine Agency. Avatrombopag is a non-chiral compound that contains 6 rings in the molecule, 5 of which are heterocycles. The 4 6-member rings are cyclohexane, piperazine, pyridine, and piperidine. The 2 5-member rings consist of thiophene and thiazole. The rings are directly connected to one another, or through an amide bond. The key steps for the synthesis of Avatrombopag involve a selective nucleophilic aromatic substitution reaction and an amide bond formation. The synthesis begins with an alpha-keto halogenation of the thiophene to give the corresponding bromide. The alpha-keto halogenation reaction usually takes place under acidic or basic conditions in an aqueous medium with the corresponding elemental halogen, chloride, bromide, or iodide. The reason why the alpha position to the carbonyl group in a ketone is easily halogenated is the ketoenol tautomerism. The enol or the enolate form of the ketone attacks the halogen, and the newly introduced halogen decreases the basicity of the carbonyl oxygen while making the remaining hydrogens more acidic. Therefore, in an acidic solution, only one alpha hydrogen is replaced by a halogen because its successive halogenation is slower than the previous. However, in a basic solution, successive halogenations are more likely due to the inductive electron withdrawal by the halogen. Condensation with thiourea produces the thiazolamine ring of the molecule in 46% yield over 2 steps. This is the Hantzsch thiazole synthesis. When a thioamide or urea reacts with an alpha haloketone, both the nitrogen and the sulfur act as nucleophiles. So, which one attacks the oxygen and which one attacks the halogen? Carbonyl groups are hard electrophiles and react well with basic hard nucleophiles. Alkyl halides are soft electrophiles and react best with large, soft, and charged nucleophiles from lower down in the periodic table. So the ketone reacts with the nitrogen, and the alkyl halide reacts with the sulfur. A possible mechanism starts with nucleophilic substitution of the alpha haloketone. The sulfur attacks the alpha carbon of the ketone, displacing the halide. The resulting isothiourea attacks the carbonyl carbon, giving a 5-member ring. Finally, a molecule of water is eliminated and the thiazole is formed. The thiazolamine is then brominated with N-bromosuccinimide in DMF. While bromothiazoles can be produced via direct bromination, thiazole is both less aromatic and considerably less electron-rich than thiophene. As a consequence, electrophilic aromatic substitution of thiazole is much less facile. However, the rate of electrophilic aromatic substitution reactions is greatly affected by the groups attached to the ring. Activating groups that donate electron density to the ring make the aromatic ring more electron-rich and the reaction faster. Thus, activation of the thiazole ring by the presence of an amino group at C2 and the activation of the thiophene by the presence of the electron-withdrawing chlorine might justify the selectivity observed in this bromination step. Subsequent nucleophilic aromatic substitution with cyclohexyl piperazine provides the desired amine in 34% overall yield. Amide bond formation with dichloronicotinic acid is accomplished by activation with phosphorus oxychloride to give the corresponding nicotinamide in 83% yield. A second nucleophilic aromatic substitution with the piperidine, followed by hydrolysis and sulformation using maleic acid, gives Avatrombopag maleate in 85% yield. Due to its electron-poor nature, nucleophilic aromatic substitution on pyridine is relatively easy, faster than benzene, but slower than pyrimidine. The addition is facilitated by the electron deficiency at the alpha and gamma carbons, which is further increased by the inductive withdrawal of electrons by the halogen substituent. The ability of the heteroatom to accommodate negative charge in the intermediates produced, Meissenheimer complexes, by inductive and mesomeric effects, favor the SNR at the 2, 4, and 6 positions over C3 and C5. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please subscribe, like, or leave me a comment down below. I'll see you in the next video. Bye!